In this video, we will discuss the problems on standard form 1 of nonlinear PDE, f of p, q equal to 0. That means the given PDE must contain p and q only, which does not contain x, y, z. Consider the problem pq plus p plus q equal to 0. Before going to solve this problem, let us recall working rule for standard form 1 once. In this working rule, we consider the given PDE f of p, q equal to 0 is taken as equation 1. In step 2, we consider z equal to ax plus by plus c is the complete solution of equation 1, where a, b, c are constants. In step 3, we substitute p equal to a and q equal to b in equation 1. Then the given equation changes to f of a comma b equal to 0. From this equation, we find the value of b in terms of a. That means pi of a. It does not contain b. That means while finding the value of b in terms of a, the function pi of a does not contain b again. After finding the value of b, in step 4, we substitute b equal to pi of a in equation 2. That gives the general solution. Mainly, in this working rule, you must remember these two steps. Consideration of z equal to ax plus by plus c as the solution, and substitute p equal to a and q equal to b in equation 1. From that, we find the value of b. Now, we move to the problem. Write the given DE PQ plus P plus Q equal to 0. This is taken as equation 1. First of all, we check whether this is a linear or non-linear. For the linear PDE, the degree of P comma Q must be 1, and the product of p comma q does not appear. But in the given problem, the product of p comma q appears, hence it is not linear. That means it is a non-linear. After finding it is non-linear, now we check whether it belongs to standard form 1 or not. That means, according to the standard form 1, the given equation must contain p and q only, does not contain x, y, z. The given equation 1 contains only p and q, hence it belongs to standard form 1. According to the working rule, in step 2, we consider z equal to ax plus by plus c is the complete solution of equation 1. Equation 1. From step 3, we substitute p equal to a and q equal to b in equation 1. In this equation, we replace p by a and q by b. Then a into b plus, in place of p, we substitute a. In place of q, we substitute b equal to 0. This is equation 3. From this, we find the value of b. Suppose we write the value of b is like this. B equal to, we take ab to the right hand side, minus ab minus a, which is not correct. Why? Because while writing the value of b, it does not contain b again. To write clearly or correctly, we write like this. To find the value of b, we write the terms containing b in left hand side. That means AB plus B. We write the terms which does not contain B to the right hand side. That means we write A to the right hand side. That is minus A. From this, we take B as common. Then A plus 1 into B equal to minus A. That implies B equal to minus A by 1 plus A. After finding the value of B, we substitute it in equation 2. That means z equal to ax plus, in place of b, we write minus a by 1 plus a into y plus c. This is the solution for equation 1. Now we go to the second problem. Solve p square plus q square equal to n into pq. Consider the given DE. P square plus q square equal to n into pq. This is taken as 1. First of all, we check whether it is linear or non-linear. Since the degree of P and Q are 2, it is a non-linear. Whether it belongs to standard form 1 or not. Since this is the partial differential equation, it contains P and Q only, does not contain X, Y, Z. So, it belongs to the standard form 1. According to the working rule, we consider Z equal to AX plus BY plus C is the solution of, complete solution of equation 1. From step 3, we substitute P equal to A and Q equal to B in given equation 1. In place of P, we write Q. In place of Q, we write B. That means A square plus B square equal to N into AB. This is equation 3. From this, we find the value of B. We write the equation like this. B square minus NAB plus A square equal to 0. This can be taken as quadratic equation in B. We consider the standard quadratic equation AX square plus BX plus C equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation in X. That means we compare B and X. By comparing the quotient of X square here is A. Here the quotient of B square is 1. That means by comparing these two, A equal to 1. Here the quotient of X equal to B. Here the quotient of B equal to minus NA. Hence the B value is minus NA. Here C equal to A square. For the quadratic equation AX square plus BX plus C equal to 0, we know the value of C. Everyone knows it. That is X equal to minus B plus or minus root of minus B square minus 4AC by 2A. In the place of X, we substitute B. Small b equal to minus. B equal to minus NA. That means minus of minus NA plus or minus root of B square. That means minus NA whole square minus 4 into A is nothing but 1 into C means A square by 2A. 2 into 1. Minus into minus plus. B equal to NA plus or minus root of N square A square minus 4 A square by 2. That equal to NA plus or minus. By taking A square is common from root, then that is A. Root of N square minus 4 by 2. We take A as common. A into N plus or minus root of N square minus 4 by 2. We substitute this value of B in equation 2. That means Z equal to AX plus BY plus C. Therefore, Z equal to AX plus, in place of B we write A into N plus or minus root of N square minus 4 by 2 into Y plus C. This is the complete solution of given PDE 1.